Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol and we are going through a series of videos on opportunities. Today we are going to take a look at editing an opportunity. In the previous videos you saw me create an opportunity and let's say we need to change something. For example, maybe the stage of the opportunity. Let's go over the Opportunities tab. And here we have the opportunities list and we can find our cat grooming opportunity right here. I am going to click the go to link to go to it. And now we can edit the opportunity. You can change to whom it's assigned to, the opportunity name, the contact, a bunch of things like that. More importantly, you may change the stage. Now, a stage is a marker within your sales cycle that is important to your business. So we have obvious ones like closed lost. Oh, I didn't get it. Or closed one, huzzah, we got the deal. And with each stage, there's a corresponding probability which will affect your pipeline. Now, the ellipsis button, or if you just click add new, will allow you to edit stages. In here, you can add brand new stages. For example, maybe the customer wants to see other reviews. I can put that in the stage category of open, and the percentage is 30%. And then I could save and close that. Great, now I can choose that for checking other reviews and the probability is 30%. And of course, if I find that too silly, I can go back in. I can select checking other reviews and now I can edit it or delete it. More actions, delete opportunity stage because that was a bit silly. Great, let's close. And I will change the stage now to just, I'll change it to proposal price quote. Let's say that Catherine called and would like to hear a quote and I will send her an estimate. And huzzah, my pipeline's now $140. Awesome. Now that she's more comfortable with me, maybe I can even edit the contact info or the customer info and I can still do it within the opportunity. Notice these two headers up here, contact info, lead customer info. By clicking it, I can edit the contact. Maybe I can put in their phone number and I can put in their Twitter name. All good. Let's just save and close that. Now I'm going to change the lead and customer info. Let's say she gave us her address. As you can see, the contact was saved because we have that phone there. I didn't really have much in there. And I will save and close this too. So the awesome thing about that is that you can edit the lead slash customer info and the contact info all from within the opportunity. So you don't have to jump all over the place and do crazy things and lose track of what you're doing. Now near the bottom, you'll find a whole whack of other tabs. The first section is additional info. You remember it. We first used it when we created an opportunity. Remember, the description is not for you to log your activity. You know how you log activity for this opportunity? New edit activity. Here you can create or even edit an activity. We'll get to editing later. But any activity you have, you should use this to create that activity. We have existing activities here. And look, here are all my activities. I can go to them and edit them if I so please. And if this is empty, then you are doing opportunities wrong. That might be a bit judgmental, but I'm right in this case. Let's go over to estimates. And I have none. So I'm going to create a new estimate. And look at that. Everything is already pre-filled for the customer. So that's great. And also we're still within opportunities. So we didn't have to navigate anywhere to create this estimate. We are thinking of you and your efficiency. I'm just going to go and fill out this estimate. And if you aren't too sure on how to make estimates, well, there's a wonderful tutorial video I already made called Estimates. I think I said this cost $200, right? I should charge more. Let's update that. And the great thing is, notice that we have it already associated with opportunity number 6, which is the one that we're in. Catherine Lee, monthly cat grooming. Good thing I named this opportunity appropriately. Let's save and close this. Huzzah! Estimate saved! Next section we have up is invoices. Any invoice that you will probably make in the future for this opportunity will show up here. And finally, we have documents. Let's say your client needs to send you specifications. Maybe she wants to send you a picture of her cat. You can upload it here for your reference. Now, when you go over to more actions, you can do a number of other things. You can delete the opportunity. I don't want to do that. And you can also duplicate the opportunity. Maybe somebody else is going to come in with more cat grooming requests. And so you can just duplicate this. Okay, I'm just going to save and go back. Because I changed the stage, my probability is now 70%, and my pipeline is now $140. If I were to go over to my home dashboard, I would be able to see that this is reflected. Oh, let's refresh the charts. There we go. I can see that this is reflected in my graphs. See, look at my pipeline. It's already up to 240. Look at all the monies. Okay. One last thing I want to touch on are activities, and in particular, activities that are related to an opportunity. Here is an activity, and it's related to my cat grooming opportunity. If I were to click go to, notice that I am warped to opportunities. That's right, any activity that is associated with an opportunity will bring up the opportunity when you edit that activity. Hope that made sense. This is so that you can have context when you are editing the activity. So if I were to scroll down, here is that activity. It's a new edit activity, and I can see what I have to do, and I can even schedule another follow-up and edit the activity to my heart's content. This screen is just like the normal edit activity screen, and if you have any questions on how to use or implement or add create activities, well, once again, I have a great video on that. I'm going to go back. And that's it. We are done with opportunities and editing opportunities. And hopefully I showed you a natural workflow for using opportunities. If you have any questions, by all means, leave a comment in the YouTube comments. Or you can tweet us at Method CRM. I hope you have a great day and take care. Bye-bye.